Yeah, hi, my name is José Brendão. I work at Diamond Light Source, and I've noticed so far there are not so many structures around, but I won't bombard you with them either. And I'll talk about Schistosoma Mansoni, what we've been doing for the last couple of years. And we have worked with two targets. When I mean targets, is target proteins, not the target disease target. Well, which incidentally are potential targets, but yeah. So a bit of corporate advertisement. I work for Diamond Light Source, which is a national facility, UK national facility. And although I work with biology, Diamond is about material science, so it's about probing matter with light, light that goes from infrared to X-rays. I work with X-rays and proteins, but Diamond does a lot more than that. And what we do is things like here on the left, on the right of the screen. This actually was not done at Diamond, it was done with the next generation facility, but it illustrates the point. Before there was a blue slide at some point, that one. So check before it happens, this one. So that's the structure, that's why we do a Diamond. And then the blue bit is when they took it to another machine and flashed a laser light on it, on the sample, and the sample itself was a crystal. And this bit of the molecule here, this is inside the protein, this bit of the molecule got excited and the electrons changed, and then it changed how the protein behaved. The protein is the yellow bit in the back here. So the point is, we do kind of imaging, but at atomic scale, and all the pharma and biotech companies, no exceptions, they do use this technique, which is called protein crystallography, at some point in their process. From 20 years ago onwards, high throughput screening and things like that made crystallography more prominent because people would always have some crystallography in the project. But over the last 10 years, it changed dramatically that protein crystallography is involved early on in the discovery stage. And at Diamond, we have another facility on top of the facility, which is called X-Chem, where we screen proteins against compound fragments, like below about 300 Dalton sizes. And we are able to screen about 1,000 compounds per week. We're now delivering 400 fragments in a week. We have had 50 proteins, projects, coming through since 2016 and collected about 50,000 soaks. So it really changed the way we're playing this. And completing my digression, I've seen on the talk by Dr. Mutavtsi that she mentioned a modest funding for the early stage, or modest funding for fellowships in their program. And that's 13 million euros from the numbers I got. But the thing is, from my point of view, we do need more early PK/PD feedback from repurposing or discovery, because we do need more like exhaustive tests rather than the ethically limited tests. And the way to do that, in my opinion, is to use alternative models, because I found this graph in the last half an hour. This is the drug discovery profile, spending profile. So these are the phases, like discovery, optimization, phase 1, 2, 3. And this is like cost in vertical. I personally work in this stage here, minus 13 years from a drug release. So, and I had noticed that from a meeting we went last week, that they were saying that by year seven, half of those $2.5 billion per drug have already been spent, and you don't know yet if it works. And at the same time, you were committing that much of money, like through this process, but very clearly at the early stages, you're spending really almost nothing, which goes back to her comment. So my simple suggestion would be to shift that money a lot to the beginning. But, and there is hope, because people are doing alternative systems and doing biology-inspired models. So the one that the last presenter, Thomas, just was describing, they were pretty much tuning. I come from a control systems background. They were tuning their model to get the answers they wanted. So if you're tuning, you can tune something that is not alive as well. So that will probably give you more or less the same results. No controversies there. So back to the schistosomiasis. So I work at Diamond. How much for time? Because I sidetracked. I work in the protein crystallography group. So my boss is Frank van Delft. We run this X-Chem project, but for schistosomiasis, I started collaborating with one university in Brazil, in São Carlos, and more recently with Fiocruz in Rio, and the UK branch of this work is me, Ray Owens from Oxford, and Nick Fernum from London School of Tropical Diseases. And we had lots of people coming, a few people coming to train through a Newton Fund or through Brazilian money as well. So my first project was one we've been working more or longer on, is the nucleotide pathways for schisto. And the putative target was the salvage pathway, because the parasite does not have ab initio production of purines. So that was the idea. And it all sparked from PNP, which was the work from my collaborator in São Carlos, and but he then said, "Oh, if we're doing PNP, why don't we do them all?" And that's where the facility spirit really kicked in, because at the time we were at the OPPF, which is next door to Diamond. They do high throughput screening, so that in 8 months' time worth of people around here, we went from having just PNP2 to having 19 solubilized proteins of this pathway and 10 structures from the pathway. And yeah, so worth of note for this pathway is that this branch here, which, so this as it is similar to the human, but like for malaria, the Plasmodium falciparum does not have these two guys here, these two branches here, and HGPRT, which is the one before PNP, is the one target for malaria. So that was kind of the rationale for this one. And we run PNP2 through XCAM, which is the other facility we have at Diamond, and this illustrates the type of output. So the idea is you have a system, you have a protein, and then you expose that protein to lots of fragments, and you get this, the green here is the protein structure, and the other colored things are the fragments you saw out of those 400, in this case was 1,200 fragments. But the idea is that here in the box you have the active site, and you have all these things that bind to the active site, but you also have all these other things that bind elsewhere, which could be allosteric modulators and things. There could be some artifacts as well. But this is the type of information you get. You get the protein here, and you get the compound there with like yes, no answer to does it bind or not. So these docked poses here can become the anchors for compound development. That's how it's designed. In the case of PNP2, so in PNP, we chose to PNP2, which was not the original PNP, and because it had just a few mutations in the active site. But funnily enough, PNP2 does not like inosine. It actually likes cytidine instead. So from few mutations in the active site turn it from purine to pyrimidine processing protein. And that's why it's a bit parked at the moment. So the second target is TGR, which is thyroredoxine glutathione reductase, which has been identified as a target about 10 years ago. And it says what the name implies. It processes both thyroredoxine and glutathione in one unit. So you have is a dimer, so the black and the blue. The dark one, the dark units are the glutathione domains, and the blue ones are the thyroredoxine domains. And there is a FAD fragment, which I forget what the name is for, is a flavin fragment. And the idea is that this fragment actually, so if you look here in space, one domain here, the other domain there, and the flavin facilitates electron transfer between the units and allows for a reduction of the substrates. And this here in green is the idea of a fragment, a compound they found, the Williams group in the US found and published just last month, a fragment that binds near to the FAD fragment and blocks NADPH binding, so it blocks the function of this protein. And that work is done between the Fiocruz lab in Rio by Floriano Pais, us here in the UK, Ray and Nick, with the support from my boss with his other project about how to follow up compounds. So that's it.